many of you already know, and as all the rest of you know by looking at me right now, our program today on young hate mongers came to an unexpectedly violent conclusion.
Crazy. I can't come into work. I can't even go to my apartment, Martha. People are dead.
Then where are you?
I can't tell you where I am. Besides, you're better off not knowing.
The people's candidate, Senator Vernon French, promises no new taxes.
And you can take that to the bank.
What am I going to do with this guy? I mean, I want to help him, but he needs help. He's all over the TV. He's some kind of a crooked cop, and he's involved in... What are you doing out of bed? I've got you.
Police are speculating that Storm, who was known to have questionable ties with various criminal elements, could have easily involved his contacts in his amazing escape, as Storm was thought to have been a murder victim, a casualty of his own greed. A widespread search is now being conducted.
Yeah. This is Mason Storm. I'd like to speak with Jerry Dunphy, please. No, it's not a joke, okay? Thanks. You know, we can't stay here. They'll trace us from the hospital right away.
I told you, nobody knows I'm here. I'm house-sitting. This place is being run by a doctor friend of my parents. He's in China on research for 6 months. The medical center only has my apartment address. Not even my friends have this number. You've got to believe me. You're safe here, okay?
Yeah.
This reporter was contacted personally by the now infamous coma cop, fugitive officer Mason Storm, who until days ago had languished in a 7-year coma. Storm gave me his word that he's innocent of all charges preferred against him in the press, and that he has indisputable proof of this. He has promised me a first look at his alleged proof.
I want 24-hour surveillance on that son of a bitch. And there's two nurses from the hospital.
Let's go.